Having defined the variables, we're now ready to move on to building the Boolean formula. We're going to start with the clauses needed so that, given a satisfying assignment, it's clear how to fill out the table. Never mind for now about whether the corresponding sequence has valid transitions. For now, we just want the individual configurations to be well defined. First, we have to enforce that at each step, the machine is in some state. Hence, for all steps I, at least one of the state variables for that step has to be true. Note that R denotes the number of states here. In this context, it's just a constant. The input to our reduction is just the string that we need to transform into a Boolean formula. The machine also can't be in two states at once, so we need to enforce that constraint as well by saying that for every pair of state variables for a given time step, one of the two has to be false. Together, these sets of clauses enforce that the machine corresponding to a satisfying truth assignment is in exactly one state after each step. For the position of the head, we have a similar set of clauses. The head has to be over some square on the tape, but it can't be in two places at once. And lastly, each square on the tape has to have exactly one symbol. Thus, for all steps I and squares j, there has to be some symbol on the square, but there can't be two. The other clauses related to individual configurations come from the start and end states. The machine must be in the initial configuration at step 0. This means that the initial state must be Q0, that the head be over the first position on the tape, and that the first part of the tape contain the input W. The rest of the tape must be set to blank to start. And finally, the computation must end in an accepting state. This we can enforce with a single clause that the state after step P of N be the accepting state.